matter what I've been through, no matter what I'm going through, no matter what's designed for me, how many know that God has got my destiny in
His
hand?
He does.
Amen. We won't be here long. Yes. And with a little thought God gave me from the word of the Lord. Amen. The book of Peter, the first epistle written by Peter, the first chapter in verse 6 is where we will take our discourse from this morning. Amen. And also, we want to deal, amen, later on. I'll deal there, and I just let that rot out. When everybody find 1 Peter, it's towards the end of your Bible in the New Testament.
Amen. Amen.
When you find 1 Peter, the first chapter, verse 6, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. The Bible reads, "Wherein ye greatly rejoice, though now for a season, if need be, ye are in heaviness through manifold temptation." And I read the 7th verse. "That the trials of your faith, being much precious than of gold, that perish, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ." Amen. Grab that neighbor by the hand and say these words. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
It is just a season.
It is just a season.
You're going through.
You're going through.
If you got somebody on the other side, tell your neighbor, neighbor,
neighbor,
it is just a season you are going through. Oh, my God, here. And you got the understanding, too, there's a purpose for the season. There's a reason for the madness that we're dealing with. God bless you, ushers. You may be seated. You know, a season is an appropriate time to make me better.
Yeah.
I need some help up in here today. See, you got to watch who you sin by today. I need some help. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
A season is an appropriate time.
It's appropriate time.
To make us better.
To make us better.
See, I got to go through what I got to go through in this season so God can develop me and to make me better. Right. I think I preached by myself today. Oh, God, here. So he understands this concept. He says, how many know present trials? How many going through some stuff? Seems like it's an attack of the enemy. Every time I turn around, something else pops up. Oh my God, here. But how many realize, but today, God is reminding me to tell you, it's just a season that you're going through. And how many know seasons change? People change. Situations change. Hey, my God, here, my God never will change.
Never change.
Yeah, let me see something, little preacher in here. It's a reason to this madness. As I begin to look at it, the trial of your faith. How many realize that God knows you got to go through?
Yeah.
The theme of suffering is that through this epistle, we are called to rejoice in our trial. That seems like an oxymoron.
Yeah.
How in the world do I rejoice when I'm going through?
Yeah, right.
I thought I had some help. I thought it was the real folks on this
side.
Yeah. How can you be happy when hell is breaking loose?
All right.
How can you be excited when you broke?
All right.
I know that's
and
right.
And come to church and say, God is good all the time. And you can't even feed yourself.
All right.
Come on now. Hey, got no real folks in here today. We are called to rejoice in trials because remaining faithful to Christ in the midst of them will purify our faith and result in praise and glory and honor both to us and to the Lord at His coming. How many of God gets excited when you hold on?
Yeah.
All right. Can I find some help in here? How many realize the trying of your faith is not to destroy you, but the trial that you go through with is to make you better?
Yes.
You get to cry like mom inside. You know what the thing about it is too? I'm better now. I'm wiser now. Because of a present circumstance and the situation I'm in. I think I'll preach in a minute in here. But he goes on to tell us in this particular text, my brethren, count it all joy.
Yeah.
My God, when you fall into Man, can I talk to some real folks? That sounds strange in here, don't it? When I'm going through, what about my worst? Then God get more praise.
Yeah,
I'm ready to lose myself. When I'm at my worst, God gets the more praise. It's easy to praise Him when you got money in the bank. It's easy to praise Him when you got food in your cabinet. It's easy to praise Him when you're able to take care of your home and your children and your family. But when you can't do none of those things and you said, I got one of them anyhow, praise.
Yeah.
I'm praising Him not because of what I'm going through,
right,
but I'm praising Him because joy is not continued upon what I have.
Right.
But joy is continued upon what God has done for me.
Yeah.
This joy that I have, of many kinds. How many know that's what we're living in with? We're living in a time that are many trials. You know what I mean? People just start acting crazy. You never know them before. You know what I mean? You're so important to certain people nowadays. Many of you got many haters. You don't even understand why. We all one paycheck from the poorhouse. And you worried about my little 2 pennies when you got 5 pennies. But how many realize that the God that I serve will make me look good even when I'm broke? Maturity. This is what God wants us to do, Karen. He wants us to grow up. Yes. I think can only reach full maturity. Oh my God, here with trials and opposition. If we never tried, we can never reach full maturity.
Right.
How many know it's a process that we got to go through?
Yes.
You got to be lied on.
Yeah.
All right.
You must be talked about.
Yes.
How many realize because greater than he is in you?
Yes.
That he is in the world. See, a lot of y'all don't even realize in you already.
All
right. A lot of you haven't reached your potential that God has in store for you because why? You ain't never been squeezed.
Yeah.
See, the only way you women can get the perfume out, you know the little ball squeeze ball y'all have to smell good. You don't spray it all one time like take it off and pour it on your hair. But how many know every once in a while when you're going from fragrance, how many know you pump it and squeeze it?
Yeah.
But every time the devil squeezes you,
yeah.
A sweet smelling seed. The Lord, I'm doing all I know how to do. I'm doing the best I can do. And see, like the more I do, ooh, the worse the things get. How many know sometimes the devil lied to you and said, when you were in the world, you didn't have all these issues.
All right.
And the reason that these issues are because why? He already had you.
Yeah.
But as soon as you turn it over to Jesus,
yeah,
all hell broke loose.
Yeah.
People start calling you, ain't calling you in 20 years.
All
right. Got no help now. They miss you.
Uh-huh.
And you need to call it what it is. It's the devil.
Yeah.
Yeah, moving on today, brother. Trials are sometimes brought into our lives so that God can test the sincerity of our faith.
Yes.
Yeah. It's easy to praise God with stuff.
Yeah.
Can I get some witnesses in here?
Yes.
I'm not trying to excite nobody today. It's easy to praise God with stuff.
Yes.
But we got to praise God when it ain't got no music.
Yeah. All right.
Y'all know how you been singing in the bathroom? You say you can't sing in church because you can't care a tune. But you don't care because when you be praising God in your bathroom, when your shower is going, you can shower your microphone and you be. Folks in the house say, shut up in there. Got no help now. Am I doing all right? Scriptures nowhere teach us that trials in life are an indication that God is displeased with us.
Right.
Because we go through, God, that don't mean God's displeased with us. Helping you today.
Yes,
instead, they indicate that God recognizes our faith and has confidence in our commitment to him.
Yeah.
See, God will not allow trial to come your way unless he thinks you can handle it.
All right.
I'm going to talk to this side now.
Yes, yeah.
See, God, the things that happen to you are not circumspectly. Right. They just don't have actually happen
to
you. Do you realize that God, the devil can't even come to your house unless God give you permission?
That's right.
I'm going to look y'all way over here because y'all don't know me. I don't know about that, Pastor. But I'm going to realize that the devil got to go up to heaven.
Yeah.
He's got to ask God, can I go over to Sister Beverly's house?
Yeah.
He said, yeah, but you're limited in what you can do.
That's right. All right.
I'm going to give you directives.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to give you instructions.
Yeah.
Go and touch a pocketbook.
Yeah.
And that's nothing. Don't touch your body. Don't touch your house. That raggedy car. Don't mess with it. It's going to roll until I'm ready to change.
All right.
And here comes that bully. Here comes this bluff. Knocking on your door.
All right.
Who is the devil?
Uh-huh.
It's your season to be tested.
All right.
And you need to get excited when the devil tells you, oh my God, how many know the devil leads for a season?
Yes, he does.
Y'all know you have some ups and you have some downs. You wonder why you're doing all that. And every time God starts stretching you,
I know.
The devil shows up.
Yeah.
Every time you get a got all in front of you stressing month and month, can't pay nothing, can't you stressing out, ulcers all in your body, then one day God said, let them come get it. Then you call the folks yourselves and I can't pay y'all, but come get your stuff.
Yes,
and then show them where it's at. This is what I left and I got. And then when they leave, give God a
trials.
I got some help now. It goes on to tell us that for our light afflictions, which is but for a moment, waits for us as a more exceedingly in eternal waiting glory. How many know the things we're going through ain't worth mentioning? Be real with yourself. A lot of us got problems because we eat too much.
All right.
I'm preaching now. They should have shouted a while ago. You know the thing about it is, you know, we got blood pressure problem. We got all kind of problems. But yeah, you taking blood pressure pill and you say you diabetical. And then you got all the greens and all that fat back in the green. I can't eat that stuff without fat. I got, you know, when you look at your plate this tall, and you talk about you diabetes. Northern people laugh that way. We talk in the South. But I already know what the Apostle Paul wrote something. He said, for I reckon. Now, reckon is a country word. Can I get some belief over here? Reckon is a country word. It's in the Bible. It's in the Bible. For I reckon that the suffering of this present time is not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. Woo, what are you saying, preacher? I'm saying that all the suffering in this world at this present age, sickness, pain, misery, disappointment, poverty, mistreatment, if you got, I'm about to touch and say, ouch, sorrow, persecution, and trouble of any kind must be considered insignificant when compared with the blessing, privilege, and glory that will be revealed in us by Jesus Christ. Thank you. Lord